pressure up the ice, and then they're off to the races.
There's one back from Alex Tuch. He goes over the glove of Ranta, and Buffalo's on the board. After going down three.
Well, the local fans were jeering them after that long shot on Ranta, and the Buffalo Sabres knew from their bench. I mean, you can tell. I mean, this is a young team. Yes, it is. But this is a team still with a lot of experienced players in the roster and not happy with.
Now he shoots that off the leg. Bounces across to the near side. Play back to Galeen. Over to Cousins. Galeen, Thompson shoots, scores! That's his 15th power play goal this season, and the Sabres make it 1-0.
I'm not sure how you can describe this shot other than magnificent. But it all starts with a point to Galeen. He's the guy that gets the setup more times than not, right in the wheelhouse of Thompson. And here it goes back, Cousins over to Darlene, and there it is. Man,
he didn't have to play for all those
people here. As I mentioned, 60. Here's Middlestad, shoots, scores! Beats Marks from far side, and the Sabres go up 2-0.
Markstrom saw this or not. I mean, he'll make this save 9 times out of 10. Middlestad just drags it towards the middle. And there's traffic, but I mean, that's a play that the goaltender has to have in a one-goal game. Now, Tanev is there, but Middlestad just catches Markstrom deep, throws it up over his left shoulder. And just like that.
Anderson. Olofsson over the red line with Cousins, burst of speed, Cousins to the net, save Copley, loose puck, they score! Off of Copley and dribbling over the goal line.
The Kings do get it to the outside, but that flip pass, passing to space, you can see just goes off the left inside skate of Copley, but with Cousins there, he gets his head up, it was the pass at the blue line. The pass at the blue line that...
Angled to Cribbs. Let's start down the wall. Cribbs off the boards. Power. Middlestad feeding the middle. Olofsson, a redirect, is in the net. Peyton Cribbs. And Buffalo. Converts on the power play. That is their first power play goal in 5 tries of the man advantage tonight.
Olofsson has a chance right there to shoot. But he senses the fact, and it's happened all night, where Copley's been able to see pucks. So instead of trying it through the goaltender, you go around the goaltender with a pass. And the Sabres within 3 right now, so...
...that he does make, well, why not? I mean, this young man has certainly blossomed the last 2 seasons.
Consecutive 30-goal campaigns, wow! Off the faceoff, a bit of a misfire, and it was steered aside by Dostal, and from behind the goal line, banked in by Tyson Jost.
When it's kind of an off-speed shot coming your way as a goaltender, you have too much time. And you could see Dostal steers it into the corner, but then watch the stick and the pad come off the ice. So it gets underneath the left pad, clips him on the right heel, and then trickles in over the line.
Thompson brings it back in. He'll launch one and a stick save, or excuse me, a pad save. Boy, Dostal lost that rebound and he was out of position for a moment. Thompson hammers one home. It's 2-0.
Yeah, that's where he does his damage. It's a lot like Alex Ovechkin, the way he sets up on that faceoff dot, a right-handed shot. And the difficulty for a goaltender is that he's so big. Sometimes you overcommit to the player's body, and so you're not set up on the angle of where the puck is being released from. The big man Thompson just blows it right over the left leg and under the glove of Lucas Dostal.
Goes wide, pass across, and misfiring on the one-timer. There's Quinn. Quinn gets it back on the goal line, puts it right between the circles, and they score! 3-3.
Boy, this is the definition of a bang-bang play right here, because this pass to Peyton Krebs, and he does a great job. Look how much he gets on this. There's the pass, Quinn to Krebs, and my goodness, all in one motion, he just rips it. Gostel can't get down early enough to take away the bottom of the net, and another puck that goes five hole.
Goal line, and now Klingberg will go off the glass and out. Owen Power under duress gets it over to Mattias Samuelsson. Quick puck movement, and Mittelstadt fires short side and scores. Oh, boy, he looked off Lukasz Dostal and then came back high short side.
Yeah, a little deception there contributes to this strike by Mittelstadt, but the shot is perfect. Developing, but you know, Henrik was getting back. Klingberg did a good job of moving him to the outside, but he's just inside the faceoff dot, and look where he put that.
Brown on the wraparound, and Comrie kept it out. Out of the box is Tuck. And he scores! Oh, he overskated it, reached back, and went off the post and in.
Boy, that puck just kind of laid there for Alex Tuck. And the right-hander just ripped it up top, and again, it's perfect up into the corner. Here's the rush up ice. Tuck had just jumped out of the box. Loses possession, comes right back to him. And that time, I think Dostal would tell you he's a little bit off his angle. Now, the stick of Ben Walk
it down. Eric Comrie trying to make it two straight wins. He last played in late January and won in Winnipeg. Gergensens goes high and beats Dostal. It's 6-3.
Well, it's like deja vu all over again, isn't it? Very similar. And there's the turnover at the blue line. Josu's had a very strong game. Jumps on that puck. Eventually it comes to Gergensen's, and again it's another high shot over the left hand of the goaltender Dostal.
Toronto ducks 4 for 5 on the kill tonight. Puck comes in front and they get another one. Seventh of the night as Dylan Cousins outweights Dostal.
What a pass to spring Dylan Cousins. Well, what a great pass. Right here, boy, Alex Tuck. He has really come on in this game. Didn't really notice the big line of the Sabres early on, but Alex Tuck has certainly made his presence known here.
Pretty good third man. That allows their D to be involved.
Buffalo back in. A chance for Dylan Cousins. He scores! Dylan Cousins with his 20th of the year, and the Sabres up 1-0.
They just come in wide on the zone. Terrific job by Cousins just to use the fact that he's got the size and the speed. Now, it's not a great goal because of the angle. Look at the shot for Cousins. This is never a bad play. Fire it at the net, and it just goes five hole on Kaapo Kähkönen. And Kaapo looked at that one. You can see his reaction. But it's heads up all the way. It beats Hurdle along the boards.
Little big Tage Thompson.
Got to take a hit to make a play, get the puck out.
Skinner back in. And now far side, a chance for Owen Power, and he scores. Owen Power, his fourth of the year. Buffalo back in front.
As soon as the puck comes out in the neutral zone, look at them kick it into gear. One guy attacking, two guys attacking, and that provides... Boy, that was a really nice play as you enter the zone, and Owen Power just goes backhand, five hole, but he jumps in. There's a second man jumping in as well.
Jokke Harju, he's checked hard by McDonald. Thompson from behind the net, gets it out front, and Jeff Skinner scores! That's 7 games in a row! He has scored against the Sharks! It's 3-2 Buffalo!
This is terrific work by the Buffalo Sabres. They get the puck in, now they get heavy on the forecheck. Tage Thompson in there does the work. Now the Sharks should be okay here. You look like they've got it. Jacob McDonald has it, but look at the long reach by Tage Thompson. That little extra reach, and that gets it
up, but not out. Into the corner. Here's Dahlin for Buffalo.
Gets it past Couture, and then it's out of the reach of Bonino. Empty net here for the Sabres, and Alex Tuck will put it in to make it 4-2.
By the Buffalo Sabres, works again in their favor. Alex Tuck puts it in the empty net.
Still wonder if Kyle Dubas will add more on the back end for Toronto. And you wonder if a game like this only adds to his enthusiasm to want to make another move. Here comes Quinn! Score! Young Jack Quinn, the 21-year-old, with his ninth of the year, the eighth overall pick in 2020. He's got a sweet pair of hands.
And now Quinn able to pick this puck up in the neutral zone. A good play by Mittelstadt, you know, to kind of win that puck and chip it up the wall to a charging Quinn, and that right-hand shot.
Guy that might get the room jump.
Yeah, you think, you know, a guy that comes in could kind of give them a little bit of a jolt. I think for Kevin Adams, he's just so cognizant of the fact that...
Oh, what a goal! Alex Tuck through the entire Maple Leaf roster, found his way in a shooting position and beat Samsonov far side, and it's 5-2.
Well, Alex Tuck, one of those guys that has really had a terrific year for the Sabres, and here he's just able to transport this puck through the neutral zone, something they couldn't do much through the first two periods, and he gets movement to his right, and then he picks off that far side. You can see in that angle how far Samsonov was.
Oh, Ryan O'Reilly denied by Craig Anderson, who's having a phenomenal period. Dahlin now the other way. Skinner's in. Shot, score! It's a two-goal game. The Sabres aren't dead yet.
Sabres go down the other way. And a little pass to the weak side, and Jeff Skinner's able to find daylight on the short side, and the Sabres have some life here with 3:31 to go.
Boy, he scored some big goals, including Game 7 against Toronto last year with two.
Buffalo back the other way. Here comes Dahlin. Centers it, and he scores. Rasmus Dahlin, I'm not sure whether he was shooting or just trying to feed it across, but either way, it goes in, and it's a tie game.
Kucherov will kind of loop up at the top, see, and he gets in behind Dahlin. Dahlin realized that, and because he's had a heck of a year, this is an excellent setup there by Krebs. He circles out of the corner, he's got time. Kuch can't find him, and it's a lucky goal. But when you're a talented player and you're having a good year, you get lucky goals. It was definitely a pass.
And now Skinner back for Buffalo. They've got an odd man rush. Skinner in across, Thompson scores. Sabres, and it's 2-1.
Hagel, who had the puck on the right wing side, when he turns the puck over, now it's a 3-on-1. Chernak's the only guy back, and he can't prevent the pass across. There's where Hagel turned the puck over. Ian Cole, you don't see. Chernak's got three guys, not two. He's doing the smart thing. He's favoring. He's always hit hard on the wall.
Centering attempt goes right through. Met by Cole, back in towards the net, kicked out by Comrie, and now here's a breakaway for Thompson, in, he scores! They call him TNT in Buffalo, and he's got a couple here in the second.
Cole is trapped, but it's the quick up play and that long pass. I think that was Skinner again.
Steven Stamkos. It's worked back by Stamkos towards Hedman, and poke free. Trying to break away is Mittelstadt. He's dumped there by Cologne in the back here. Now a chance in front, and they score again. This is Quinn. Gets the shot to go through.
For them all year. Gets the loose change after Mittelstadt knocked it into the corner. Victor Hedman comes back and gets into the corner, but that leaves a 2-on-1 out front.
Hedman. And now, look out, Thompson, loose, in, scores! He's having a night again. That's a hat trick for Tage Thompson.
And then the flip into the neutral zone where Kucherov comes over to help and doesn't look behind him. If he had stayed in his own lane and Thompson was coming in behind him, Hagel didn't need any help. But when Hagel took a pass at the puck and didn't quite handle it, Comrie's been good, even though five goals with some saves he's made.
Here's Stamkos again. Stamkos lost the handle and down the ice they come. It's Lyubushkin. Ilya Lyubushkin shoots and scores. Are you kidding? Ilya Lyubushkin, of all people, ends this one tonight in Tampa.
Stamkos felt like he was tripped and he was upset, but that's what led to the breakaway. Lyubushkin came out on him and then there was nobody back. Stammer was the last guy back. Vasilevsky thinks he's going to go far side. He goes top shelf on the short side. Here'll be a better look. Stammer tries to go into the middle of the ice. The stick is up around his waist, and he certainly has got an argument there. That one was right up on his hands. Normally you see
got it through to Verhaeghe. Checked by Joki Haru. Here comes Skinner the other way against Ekblad. He's got the trailer. It's Thompson in front to the backhand, and then the shot, they score. Skinner. Sabres get one off the rush and strike first.
Here it is. They lose control, and here comes the Sabres with a counterattack. They hit the trailer. That's Thompson, and it goes right back and in the net. That's how quickly that they can strike if you mishandle that puck, which the Panthers did at that offensive blue line.
Well, you see the skill. Thompson picks it up there. Olofsson, power, touch pass, Thompson. Here's Tuck in front, shooting, he scores. And now it's 2-0 Buffalo on the power play goal.
Quick puck movement. Watch, it comes across. And there's 1, 2, and 3. And then that puck, when it, once it goes down low, now there's all kinds of time for Tuck. He's got 4 goals in the last 5 games.
Skinner works free. Forsling knocked the puck away. Thompson gives it back to Skinner. Sharp angle shot, and he scores! Jeff Skinner's second of the game found its way by Bobrovsky upstairs. 3-1.
He worked hard. There's a Thompson gives it to him, and look at it, just a bad angle shot. Bobrovsky had already committed to come across. He was down, goes off his shoulder and underneath the crossbar.
Barreling down the boards. Now it's Cousins. He feeds it ahead. Mittelstadt back to Cousins. Scores! The workhorse from Whitehorse on his horse.
Nice job just chipping this one up the wall. Mittelstadt once again just pulls up. Perfect pass across to him. Dylan Cousins able to corral it. There's Mittelstadt, lays it right across. Dylan Cousins under pressure, goes back across the green, just inside the post. And that's a huge goal here for the Sabres. With
a half to go near the opening period, we're tied at one apiece. Here's a chance right down the middle, scores! Well, that is some kind of shift by Tage Thompson. He stuck with it and then buried it to put Buffalo back on top.
Yeah, Tage Thompson, 40 of the year here. Look at him coming right down the gut once again. Look at the quick shot. And just nothing into it. Just steps in. It's in tight, close to his feet. Drags that last back leg. Look where it's at and the power he's able to get on it. That puck was not late.
Skinner continues to the front of the net. No pass yet. Behind the net. Now it's out front. Scores! Jeff Skinner jumps on the loose puck. Sabres back on top, 3-2.
Talked about it in between periods, and he's doing a good job so far in this game. He's all over it. And there's Quinn. He's going to feed.
Jost will bring it left side up. Bring it left side up for Buffalo. Dumped down into the corner. Irwin takes that neatly off the skate, carries it to the corner, met by a pair of Sabres. Kyle Poulsen comes away with it in front. Garbage, it scores!
oop-a-dope in the corner and into the front of the net, and they bury it to go up 4-2.
Here, but look at this. Kyle Aposo over in the corner doing a nice job along with Jost. Jost ties up two Washington players, allows Aposo to slide out with the puck right here. The nice little quick pass across to Zemgus Girgensons once again. Zemgus finds the back of the net just on a quick release. He hits a stick.
Van Riemsdyk, cross-ice pass. Ovechkin standing at the Sabres' blue line. Mittelstadt comes back. Good speed. Mittelstadt for Cousins. Out of his skate, drops it back. Power in front. Backhand scores! Oh, Vinny, welcome back! That's called a Sabre dance right to the Capitals' goal, and it's 5-3 Buffalo.
They're not even coming with speed. They're coming with speed and puck movement. Look at this. Just tic-tac-toe. It's to everybody. Everybody in the line touches this puck here before it ends up going into the net. And Vinny Hinostroza on the backhand stepping around. Kemper for the final dagger after Cousins drops that puck to Mittelstadt.
Sabres 40 goal scorer helping his team out of his own end and then creating a scoring chance. Back the other way is Dowd. And that's a turnover by the Capitals. Sabres with the gift will bring it in. Pass it across. Here's Cousins. Oh, that was magic. Dylan Cousins shoots and scores. Buffalo to a 6-2 lead.
Watch this as they work their way up. Jack Quinn's coming across. He gets to the middle of the ice. And what a pass right there by Jack Quinn.
Get back there to show for the pass. Cousins slides it across. Mittelstadt in behind the net. Watched by Gustafson in front. Cousins scores! Hat trick, Dylan Cousins! Throw him out! Throw him out! 7-4 Buffalo is the workhorse from Whitehorse.
To Cousins, and he just makes the move in front, goes to the backhand, and there it is.
Start in the first period. Part of 9 goals the Buffalo scored the first time. Thompson comes back and scores! Oh, you said it. He likes facing the Jackets. This game is tied at 1.
And for him right now, it's the Columbus Blue Jackets. And this is the type of response you want. It's a turnover in the neutral zone, how it all starts. And Skinner, what a pass from Skinner. A no-look backhand pass, and Thompson showing off his shot right here. The hard part about that, he shoots in stride. You don't know that shot's coming. He's striding along, shoots this puck, and just an absolute.
Samuelson stick, and up ahead for Buffalo. Quinn races forward. He shoots and scores! The Sabres needed that.
His 11th of the year. First rounder in 2020 draft. Continues to get better for this Buffalo Sabres team. You can see him, he calls for it. He says, give me the puck as he comes down that far side. Beats Merzlikins. Far side, over the pad, underneath the blocker.
Merzlikins. Power for Krebs. Back for Power. Straight on. Paterka scores! Muscles it through Merzlikins. And it's a one-goal
and sink at Merzlikins, and this one ends up squeaking through. And it's not Olsen with the one-timer, but it's Paterka. You can see this time they don't take away. It's going to Olsen. Now they say, Paterka, go ahead. You can fire it. He finds a way to beat Merzlikins. He can't believe it. And Buffalo is right back in this one.